Hello everyone, my name is Marina and I'm happy to present you our project ORFhunteR Automatic Identification and Annotation of Open Reading Frames in Human Embryonic Molecules. This project is cooperation of Belarusian State University and Luxembourg Institute of Health. The problem is to separate coding and encoding embryonic molecules and identify open reading frames. Here is the structure of mRNA molecule. It has 5' UTR, 3' UTR, and coding protein coding region, open reading frame, started with start codon and ended with stop codon. What is identification of open reading frames? We work with transcript data, and identification of open reading frames means to establish the coordinate of start codon and stop codon of this ORF. Open reading frames have some characteristics. First, start codon is ATG. It not only one, but the most common. Then stop codons are TAA, TAG, and TGA. And important, then start codon and stop codon should be in frame. Looking forward these characteristics, we can find several subsequences that potentially able to be an open reading frame. They are candidates to be an open reading frames. So, ORF candidates, all subsequences corresponding to these three conditions. To identify and annotate open reading frames, we propose our ORFhunteR method based on vectorization of nucleotide sequences into sequence-dependent features and a random forest classifier. ORFhunteR is identification of the open reading frames by hunting with R codes. In our pipeline, we're working with sequencing data of transcripts, and the first step is vectorization. Vectorization is the process of transforming sequence data into the vector of features. After vectorization, we have classical for machine learning table with numerical features. Next step is model training. You can train model on your own data or take our pre-trained model. Next is identification of the open reading frames and annotation of them. Now for our trained data, we downloaded ECCB dataset and we got 128,000 of well-annotated protein coding mRNAs, and we added 4,000 of non-coding RNA. After extraction of ORF candidates, we got 113,000 of highly confident true open reading frames and 108 of pseudo open reading frames. Pseudo open reading frames looks like real ORF, but they're not translated into proteins. For our test data, we downloaded ensemble dataset and we had 56,000 of mRNA and 74,000 of sequences from non-coding RNA. To avoid different artifacts, we filter out mitochondrial transcripts, incomplete transcripts, and transcripts with non-canonical start codons. We vectorize our sequences into 104 features. There are frequency of mono D and T nucleotides, nucleotide correlation factors, length and logarithm of length, and category position frequency. This is our training dataset after vectorization in space of principal components. As you see, our features well separate coding and non-coding transcripts. Moving to prediction, firstly we compared different prediction models. As a result, we choose random forest due to accuracy and processing time. We used random forest with 500 trees. Next, we discover feature importance in our model. The most important features are parameters of CPF model and open reading frames length. Less informative features are nucleotide frequencies and nucleotide correlation factors. For ensemble database, our train set, we got accuracy 94.9%. This figure is demonstrating the distributions of probability values obtained from our model for different transcripts. The closer to one, the more likely that candidate is coding. As you can see, distribution for true mRNA molecules is around 1. All algorithms were implemented in ORFhunteR R package published on Bioconductor. This is the scheme of our package. Let's see in details. The pipeline we proposed started with loading a set of transcripts, then identification of all possible ORF candidates. Next step is vectorization. Here we develop two in public functions to get CPF model functions and correlation factors on C++ code to speed up the algorithm. Next step is optional. You can train your classifier on your own data. or skip this and use our pre-trained model on SMBI data. Then the main function is prediction of true ORF coordinates. Next, extract sequences from initial transcripts. And now we can move to ORF characterization. We can identify the premature termination codons, carry out in silico transcription into proteins, and the last function is annotation of open reading frames. Here's the output of annotation function. The table includes transcript ID, length of 5 UTR, type of start codon, start and stop codon coordinates, type of stop codon, PTC status of stop codon, length of open reading frame, length of 3' UTR, molecular weight, isoelectric point of protein sequence, and potential protein interaction index. In addition, we created a web application for ORFhunteR. Here you can upload your FASTA file with transcripts, choose prediction probability threshold, and as a result, you will get the list of your predictive open reading frames. And you can download this list in a text file. In conclusion, I want to say that we implemented the efficient computational approach for identification of open reading frames in mRNA molecules based on vectorization sequences and the random forest classifier. The accuracy on test set is 94.9%. And our advantages are that it requires less computing resources and works much faster than neural networks. To prevent overfitting, our vectorized features helps. Random forest classifier is nice and have nice applicability, and we implemented parallel calculations for a large data sets. I would like to say thanks for all our team, and thank you for your attention.